It's lights out and away we go. So Bottas leads Lewis Hamilton. Max Verstappen leads Pierre Gasly. They win here in Imola. Valtteri Bottas comes home to make it a Mercedes 1-2. Hamilton extends his championship lead.
Hello everyone, this is the new video and a brand new sport altogether. The F1, Formula 1, what a beautiful sport it is. And this week we have Emilia Romagna Grand Prix, also known as Imola Grand Prix. This video is in the collaboration with F1 India Unofficial. Yeah, these bunch of guys are amazing, a big shout out to them. India mein hai fan base achha khasa volume one, Formula 1 ka. But yes, we still hope to see a miracle kick up, Formula 1 aayega, we'll get to watch our favorite racers zoom pasting those cars. Aayega, kabhi na kabhi to aayega. Let's move ahead for the time being with this upcoming race. So these are the race details. Please note that FP1, FP2 and FP3 timings have been changed due to the funeral service of Royal Highness the Prince Philip, Duke of Edinburgh. That will take place on Saturday. So in order to mark the respect and to avoid any clash with the service, these are the new revised timings for the following race. Let's talk about the Indian Standard Time. The FP1 starts at 2:30 PM, whereas FP2 on the same day starts at 6 o'clock. On Saturday we have FP3 at 2:30, whereas the qualifying race will take place at 5:30 PM. This is all about Indian Standard Time. Now we have the main race on Sunday itself. It starts at 6:30 PM and it's going to be a beautiful race, right? Look at this gorgeous circuit. It's definitely one of a kind and one of the most beautiful races to hold. Let's talk a bit more about Imola, or maybe if some people are familiar with Emilia Romagna. So Imola is located approximately 25 kilometers east of Bologna in Italy. The map of Imola has been drawn by Leonardo da Vinci in the early 16th century and is still in use. So of course this has a historic value as well. So let's talk now about the GP. The Imola Grand Prix is known as we mentioned, Emilia Romagna Grand Prix on present day, but it also has various different names as Italian Grand Prix or San Marino Grand Prix. Also this venue is the home race for three teams, Ferrari, Alfa Tauri and Alfa Romeo. So coming on to the circuit, look at this beautiful circuit. It is 4.909 kilometers long with 63 laps around the corner. The DRS zone is straight around the pit. It has 19 corners, 10 to the left and 9 to the right, whereas corner number 8, 10 and 16 are more or less straight only for these modern F1 cars. They can zoom past through anyone. They just don't need to brake around these corners. Coming on to some records of this track. Yet again, the last winner was Lewis Hamilton with, yeah, everyone knows, Mercedes AMG F1 team. Whereas the most wins was from Michael Schumacher, which was 7. The most wins for Constructors Trophy is shared between Williams and Ferrari. They have 8 each. Whereas the most wins for the engine suppliers are Renault and Ferrari, 8 each. The lap record is held by Lewis Hamilton. Yeah, everyone guessed that right. Congratulations. 1:15.484, which was in last season itself. Coming on to our prediction for the final starting grid of the main race. Yeah, we have gone with everyone predicts it's Max, Hamilton and Bottas in the top 3, just revolves around these 3 people. But yes, we have thought a lot and we have come to a proper conclusion. To be honest, a proper prediction. We predict that Max will zoom past Hamilton this time. We know how close he was last time. Hamilton at 2nd, Checo at 3, he is a fantastic driver. The so many cars he just overtakes, it's phenomenal, it's beautiful to see that. Bottas at number 4, the McLaren duo at 5 and 6 respectively. We have predicted that Leclerc will come forward with number 7, Gasly at 8, Sainz at 9, and yes, Yunoda was very impressive in the first race. He was very impressive. Coming on to the lower midfield, we have gone with Alonso at 11, Raikkonen at 12, the Aston Martin duo at 13-14 respectively. They seriously need to improve. Ocon at 15, Giovinazzi at 16, Russell, the talented guy, at 17, Mick Schumacher at 18, Latifi 19, Mazepin at 20. With the rear suspension really helping Red Bull this season, and they are in touch with Mercedes this time. They have serious competition now. I'm telling you guys. Plus, the McLaren duo, they have improved as well. It will be a tough time. It will be a tough season. The midfield looks so strong. The battle for contenders is so strong. The drivers look promising. And it's an even balanced season this time. So, who will stand at the podium this time? Tell us your views in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. We look forward to the beautiful race on Sunday.